When wave energy is high, coastal erosion takes place, resulting in a variety of coastal features. The rate of erosion is moderated by the mixed geology of the coastline. Hard rocks such as basalt are more resistant and thus erode much slower than soft sedimentary rocks such as limestone. We call this differential erosion. Coastlines that have an alternating geology of hard and softer rocks results in the formation of headlands and bays, as can be seen here in Port Macquarie. The places where the rock is harder has headlands jutting out. Where the rock is softer, more erosion takes place and bays form. Over time, the headlands become more exposed to the erosive power of waves due to wave refraction. This occurs because the waves slow down first in shallower water, forcing the refracting part of the wave to break first at the headland, while the other part of the wave is travelling faster towards the beach in deeper water. The erosion at headlands results in the formation of spectacular coastal features such as cliffs, wave-cut platforms, arches, caves, blowholes, and stacks. When large amounts of water are constantly hammering away at the coastline, the processes of hydraulic action and abrasion can cause cliffs to retreat and create a feature called a wave-cut platform. Wave-cut platforms are broad, flat areas of rock that are often found at the base of cliffs and headlands. At the edge of the platform there is an escarpment. Hydraulic action is when waves smashing against cracks and joints in the rock compress the air in those cracks. The pressure created by this can eventually cause fragments of rock to break off. Abrasion occurs when wave action transports sediment which hits the cliff and gradually wears it away. Attrition also takes place, where the waves cause rocks to rub against each other. As this happens, the original rocks reduce in size to smaller and rounder fragments. As these processes take place, a wave cut notch can form at the base of the cliff. The notch forms because the force of waves is only eroding the rock between the high and low water mark. This causes the rock below the low water mark to remain. Over time, this notch gets progressively bigger until the cliff eventually collapses. As a result of collapsing cliff faces, there is a lot of debris at the base made up of large boulders. In these places, the debris from collapsed cliffs is broken down by waves. The backwash carries the debris towards the sea, forming the wave-cut platform. Then the whole process repeats and the cliff continues to retreat. Understanding the workings of erosion processes such as cliff retreat is very important for people as they impact heavily on any human coastal development. For caves to form, there must be a weakness in the headland's rock, such as a soft rock type or an existing crack. Over time, hydraulic action makes these cracks bigger and bigger until a cave forms. Sometimes a cave roof will partially collapse to form as a blowhole, such as this one here. Other times the wave will erode the cave right through to the other side of a headland to form an arch. Eventually, the ceiling of the cave will completely collapse, causing part of the headland to detach and form a vertical column of rock in the sea known as a stack. Another peculiar type of erosion feature found on rocky shores around the world is called honeycomb weathering. This formation is caused by salt crystals getting into cracks in the rock. Sea spray and wind are the usual ways for salt water to make its way into these places. When the water content evaporates, salt crystals are left behind. The rocks go through a wetting and drying process as they are often found in intertidal zones. When they dry from the sun, the crystals heat up and expand, which puts pressure on the confining rock.